Hello everyone, feel very welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We're on the way to discover how to run Pixel Gun 3D on PC, as you can see you are displaying it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and install Pixel Gun 3D so that we can enjoy this game on a Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's go buddies. First of all folks, to get started we need to launch our main browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, simply because I added the link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our Usitility website, where we have a detailed summary on just how to download and install Pixel Gun 3D on computer. We scroll down a bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we reach the site of LDPlayer. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to that game Pixel Gun 3D on the PC. As you can discover from here, we get several advantages of using the emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Then, we will proceed to download the Pixel Gun 3D by simply clicking on this button Download LDPlayer on PC that you can see here in green color. Next step is clicking on the button. And the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we are going to do is to launch the executable file, okay, then we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduce the browser to see the installation software significantly better. The installer is really simple. It consists of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path does indeed. We purely click it, and now we observe that we have here the path where the emulator is going to be placed. If we prefer to modify this folder we have to click on that browse option, therefore we pick another directory and install the emulator precisely where we would like. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on back. So I simply click on install. Right now, before starting the installation of this emulator, it is also possible that it's going to suggest us a number of application deals to put on the desktop or laptop. Because I do not want any of these software programs, I just press many times on the reject button. Voila! The installation starts and it is going to commence along with the download of those megabytes that happens to be shown on our computer screen. The moment you save it on your hard disk, it may be a little bit more or less MB. The download speed will go at a higher speed or slower, determined by your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Today they're going very fast. The download is done, and at this moment it continues on with the setup part. The setup will need a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your laptop or computer. The more efficient it really is, the shorter the installation time and or vice versa. If we merge the download and software installation step it can take a considerably long time, so be patient. It is now finished on my side. Now let's continue to launch the emulator for the very first time. We click on right here on the start button and the emulator is actually started. As you can observe, down here, there is a progress bar which will move forward to the right, then when it attains the finish, the emulator can be started for the first time. The fact is the emulator has already been launched there for the first time. This is the emulator desktop. Here we have it. Before we carry on, as you can discover, it has created a couple of software icons there on the computer desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player software icon will be one we're concerned with. At any time when we desire to run Pixel Gun 3D on our laptop or computer, we double-click this specific icon and therefore launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even nearly anything like this. The fact is, it's an app icon that we would most certainly never ever utilize. Why don't we do the next step, which is actually a requirement, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. To do that we will browse here to System Apps, we click on. And we will click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is launched. Here we are required to log on. At this time when we are on this page, we have to conduct this following step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore just click on Sign In. At this moment it says Checking Info. It can once in a while get blocked in Checking Info, additionally it isn't going to progress. If that's the case, you can try to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it will surely quite likely be resolved. At this moment we will enter our email address and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. As an example, you can utilize the same exact email address you are using right now in your own YouTube account. So I will type my data and I'll come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, data entered. Discover Google welcoming us and supplying us their twos. We can consent to all of them by just pressing I agree. Following, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also let it select it. It's going to produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. From now, Google Play is launched as favorite choice and instantly. Whenever the Google Play just isn't started immediately and you have no clue how to run it by yourself, I teach you how to do so. First thing is to go to the emulator desktop by clicking on this software icon marked in green color. At present, we go to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Fine, we're here into Google Play. What we are going to perform will be go here to search for apps and games. And we're going to search for Pixel Gun 3D. So there we get it, we should go through the very first result. Right here we get the game. Let's just click right here on the install link that I am showing now in green color. Therefore it will begin the installation. Straight away it would download on your laptop or computer and set up the video game. It normally takes a little while, or perhaps it might well be almost immediate. This all will depend on our connection to the web. It has just completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting this option that I'm showing in green, so that you can run Pixel Gun 3D for the very first time. We're by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to click that brand new Pixel Gun 3D software icon which has been provided. This game is launched for the first time. Now there we end up with it. I could press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume of that emulator. It's right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. That is the first one. We mouse click on this particular app icon which I'm showing in green color. Then the screen is maximized, having one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Assuming that we really want to appreciate the application using all the screen, we select this particular app icon. And we'd already be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen setting. To get out of the complete screen setting, hit the F11 key. And we might already play in regular display setting. At this moment I am starting to reveal you the computer keys mapping that is definitely quite exciting. That strategy we will probably be in a position to play the video game more easily. The first thing is to mouse click this application icon. It's now time to make the recommended configuration settings. I can put the standard settings, however if you require to adjust this, you can easily do it without any problem. I just take this chance to comment that once in a while, when commencing the Android game, a dark screen shows up. If it is like that and you experience the black display and that emulator doesn't start, I comment a plausible solution. We should go here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator options, in the advanced option we have now a multitude of screen resolutions. That is the pixel quality we've at this time opted for as favorite choice, and so we must select any of these other resolutions, for instance this one listed below. We pick it and click on save. It may tell us to reboot this emulator, and soon after rebooted, likely the emulator will launch and your black display will vanish. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, for instance, in Japanese. And therefore to set it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here within many other options, we click the language drop down. We should pick the language we wish, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. As soon as the language is selected, we would save, the emulator would reboot, and the Android game, next time we launch it, will also be in the preferred language. At present, there is another detail that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google Mail reporting that a brand new electronic device has been associated with this Google account. It will certainly ask us if we are the individuals who have connected that electronic device. Absolutely, we should not be troubled, because the emulator is behaving like an Google Android device. In order to discover which device is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And so we go here to the model option. And now we observe that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all, folks, so much for the video user demo. I anticipate you appreciated it, specifically that you thought it was handy. If that's so, allow it a pleasant like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, questions or ideas. Let them in the comment box down below. You can also leave comments on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams every once in a while. You get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of these instructional videos which are usually appearing on the screen, and see you in the upcoming training videos. Bye.